now introduce the Health Minister of Chhattisgarh, Mr. T.S. Thingdeo. Mr. Deo, thank you very much. I wanted to understand from you, what do you think is the best way forward? Obviously, we have to look at solutions. We know for a fact that there is a shortage for the black fungus medicine, that injection. First of all, if you could tell us the magnitude of the problem in your state and what would be the likely solutions that you may want to offer?
We have, till the last report I had, 102 cases of the black fungus and one death from Durg district so far. The issue is, like you mentioned rightly, the availability of injections, and a large number of injections required per patient. Our experts here have told me that between 50 to 100 injections over a period of hospitalization or treatment of about 21 days, that is the number of injections required per patient. So the large number of injections which are not available in the market is what has to be arranged, whether they are imported or whether the manufacturing, if it has not already been stepped up, it needs to be stepped up. There is no alternative but to that. There are tablets, there are other suggestions which have come. Our expert committee has let us know that you could, as a second line, azole derivatives, they have been mentioned, and then Prozac, Conazole, I'm not very conversant with these names, so I'm finding it a problem mentioning them. 200 mg four times a day, this has been suggestion.
No, sure, then, I understand.
Then other methods of prevention that can be undertaken. These are the issues that we are facing. One, shortage of the vial straight away, amphotericin B, lipid, then liposomal amphotericin B. These are the vaccines which are sought after and not available.
Yes, Mr. Deo, now here is the problem. Number one is, of course, availability, which needs to be fixed ASAP. The other problem is affordability. Now, this is a very expensive line of medication, of cure. So how are the poorest of the poor being able to, or will be able to afford it? See, because the problem is it emanates because of the use of steroids and also a badly managed diabetes. Now, among the poorest of the poor will, this is where the problem will be. As a state leader, what do you suggest on the affordability front?
Government hospitals, the government is buying these injections and making them available free of cost. It is in the private sector. If those who cannot pay, they go to the private sector, that is where there is an issue. So long as these patients are coming to government facilities, we have no issue in providing them the injections once they are available. The whole issue starts off when private people want this medication from the government help, and they tend to wean away patients who would otherwise opt for a government facility. That is where the issue of extra cost comes in. Otherwise, we are willing to pay for patients in our thing. And we are also in the process of including this as part of an extension of the Ayushman scheme, which we have taken up in our state as the Dr. Khoobchand Baghel scheme, where we are providing 5 lakh rupees for every 1 rupee ration card holder and up to 20 lakh rupees treatment for 14 diseases. So this can be added, this 20 lakh thing, because like you said rightly, one dose is costing between 5 to 7,000, and 100 doses, if it is 50, it is 2.5 lakhs. If it is 100 and 7,000, it is 7 lakhs. Just for the injection, separate cost would be there for the operation.
Injection, yeah.
Yeah,
Mr. Deo, now let's come to the other big problem. See, this is of course a side effect of the excessive use of steroids. That's what experts have said. Now the main question is, did we not see this coming? Had we seen this coming, had there been an advance warning, perhaps the procurement of the drugs could have been expedited. And secondly, what do experts have to say about the other side effects, other possible side effects while we are trying to treat COVID? I mean, if we know early, we'll be able to prepare early.
the issue here in treatment of COVID is that internationally and within the country, two lines of treatment have proven to be the most effective. One is the much simpler issue of oxygen. Its shortage is another matter, but oxygen has helped the patients the most, and the drug which has helped the patients the most is steroids. Now, the problem came, it was like you're rightly saying, was not foreseen that this would lead to this black fungus growth. It was not seen. When steroids are available at a very cheap price in the open market, there, if steroids have been rightly said to be among the most helpful drugs in this pandemic, then many people probably have gone into buying these drugs and using them without medical, let us say, supervision. So, if they have been a seriously diabetic condition and the doses have not been regulated by doctors who are in the know, then the combination of this has led to this situation. We did not see it coming. You are right. I'll accept that. But now that it is upon us, we would like to act on it as soon as possible.
Okay. Mr. T.S. Singh Deo, thank you very much for sharing your